For those of you new to this channel and joining us, welcome guys. For those of you returning, welcome back and thank you for your continued support. So as always, the readings that I'm doing here today are general tarot spreads, and what this means is it may not necessarily resonate with every Aquarius watching this, and that's okay. So please just take what resonates with you and leave aside what doesn't. For those of you who would like a personal reading with me, please feel free to reach out. My email address is listed at the bottom of the video here in the show more section below, along with the different types of readings that I offer, and you may find that those readings resonate with you more closely as they are personal and more directly relate to you and your situation. So the reading that I'm doing here today is intended for Aquarius Ascendant, Sun, Moon, Venus, and Rising. Let's take a look at the messages the cards hold for you here, Aquarius. So to begin, you've got the Three of Swords, the Hierophant, and the Star card here. Okay, so the Three of Swords, this is air energy. It rules the signs of Libra, Gemini, and Aquarius. Okay, so you could be dealing with an air sign here. Okay, the Three of Swords here shows us a heart that is pierced by three swords here. Okay, and swords, of course, governs mental energy. Okay, so words we communicate, words even we don't communicate, our thoughts, our actions, our attitude. Okay, and I feel like this, the Three of Swords each represent pain. One represents, you know, a pain that is inflicted by words, others by action, and, you know, the third is like the intent on to hurt either the emotional or the physical self. So all in all, this is pain. For some of you Aquarius, and because this is your energy, I feel like there is a wound that still festers, okay? I feel like for some of you Aquarius, you're still healing from a heartbreak, a pain, an emotional anguish, a disconnection of some sort, maybe a betrayal, because the Three of Swords is also said to represent a third party situation or an emotional, an emotional affair, a love triangle here, some sort of heart troubles or heart worries here, okay? Sadness, heartbreak, someone here letting you down, a breaking up here. But basically, there's a wound here that still festers. There is someone here whom you haven't been able to get over, emotionally speaking, okay? Someone here whom you haven't moved on. I also feel like the fact that you haven't been able to move on from this person has prevented you from moving forward in your life, especially in terms of love and romance and matters of the heart. You may be in a relationship with someone else, like physically you may be in a new relationship, but maybe you're not able to fully commit yourself to this relationship, maybe for fear of, you know, the past repeating itself, maybe for fear of this person also being able to hurt you, or maybe it's the fact that, you know, you haven't emotionally healed and moved on from this previous relationship, and therefore, you know, you've got no room or no space in your heart for this new connection or this new love that's coming in for you here. Okay, but there's something key that I feel like the fact that you are still somehow you're still connected to this person. It could be that, you know, so for some of you, it could mean that even though you've broken up with this particular someone, whoever it is that's hurt you here, that's caused this emotional pain onto you, it could be that you still are connected in some ways. So for some of you, maybe you've chose to remain friends and you're still in each other's lives. For others of you, maybe there is still unresolved feelings there, even though this person has hurt you. Perhaps a bit deceived you or betrayed you, they've broken your heart. I feel like there's still love there. There is still some lingering romantic feelings there. And maybe because of this, you're unable to move forward. But there's a wound that still festers here. And I feel like this wound is preventing you from moving on with this person. I also feel like it's rooted in the past. This heartbreak or this pain or sadness, it's rooted in the past. That's why I keep arriving at the fact that you're unable to move on, because it's someone that's hurt you in the past, okay? But as I always say, what I do like about the Three of Swords is the background here, okay? There is a lot of there's a lot of dark clouds that gather in the background, a lot of rain here, but of course we know that it doesn't rain forever, and of course we understand that every cloud has a silver lining. So eventually you will be at a stage where you will move on, you'll be able to move on from this person. eventually you'll be at a stage where you'll stop thinking about them, you'll stop being hung up on them, where you'll just no longer care, you know, who they're dating or who they have in their life. You'll just, you know, for some of you, you'll just maybe miraculously wake up one day and you'll forget about them, and it'll just be that easy. For others of you, it could take a little bit longer, but you will get there, you will move on. Okay, as denoted with the Hierophant here, the Hierophant, I feel like for some of you, you could be burying the hatchet with someone here. Okay, you could be burying the hatchet with whoever it is that this person has hurt you. Okay, it's like you could forgive someone here for a pain, for an emotional pain that's been inflicted onto you. Some of you, it's a process of forgiving and forgetting. For some of you, it's forgiving but not forgetting. For others of you, it's forgiving, and with the Star card that follows, it's reviving a connection. It's rejuvenating connection. It's giving it another go. It's like, okay, I know you hurt me, or I know there was a third party situation. I know you lied or betrayed to me, but you still want to give it another go. There's a part of you that still loves them, and you know, is holding on to a hope that it may work. And maybe because of the Hierophant, because there's a very strong sense of forgiveness attached and associated to this card. Maybe this person is, you know, they're open to prove their love, to prove their love and their devotion to you. They're willing to make their wrongs right again. They're willing to atone for their sins, for their wrongdoings here with the Hierophant. And maybe, you know, you're aware of this. They're willing to go to great measures, to great lengths, to prove to you their love to you here, okay? And there's a part of you, especially here with the Star card, that I feel like is clinging onto a hope. Whether it's a false hope or whether it's just a glimmer of hope, there's a part of you that believes that, you know, there's a lot of feelings. The fact that there's a lot of feelings still attached to this person, that the two of you have unfinished business, okay? The two of you aren't over just yet. For some of you, I feel like it's going to work out a little bit different. You'll get at a point where I feel like with the Hierophant here, you may be at a stage where you're finally ready to forgive someone here, to forgive someone who's hurt you or who's betrayed you here, someone whom you were involved with romantically. It could even be something as simple as someone who's ghosted you in the past, and maybe this week you'll reach out to them. They'll reach out and they'll just reappear just like that in your life again. And it's like, you know, not that you won't take issue, or not that you didn't take issue with what they did, but you're willing to say, you know, that's in the past, it's happened in the past, I'm willing to give this person another go. There's something there, I want to explore it, whatever it is. So it's like, for some of you, you know, you're going to forgive someone. For others of you, I feel like there's someone here who's obviously emotionally hurt you very deeply here, but you're going to arrive at a stage where you're going to be able to forgive them for that. You're going to be able to make room in your heart to actually forgive them. And with the Star card, it's going to be quite a liberating, quite a freeing experience. Because at the same time, I feel like, you know, when you're, whatever it is or whomever it is in your life that you still hate, there is, you know, you're still attaching yourself to this person, place, or thing. So you're still creating that attachment. And then when you're able to forgive someone, someone for their wrongdoings, or forgive, you know, a person, or forgive a certain situation, you know, whenever you're able to forgive someone, it's like you're slowly untying yourself, you know, you're detaching yourself from this person, or you're detaching yourself from this particular situation or this particular moment. Okay, so it's going to be quite a liberating, quite a freeing experience. And in doing so, you know, when you forgive someone, you will then be able to move on. You'll be able to, you know, detach yourself from that person, detach yourself from that pain, most importantly, and you'll be able to move on. Move on with your life, move on with finding a love, with committing yourself to someone. I'm picking up, it's a very rejuvenating and a very liberating experience, the ability to forgive something or someone that has deeply hurt you, okay? The ability to show your emotional maturity in these type of situations, because as much as it is for the other person, it's much more important for you, because you're freeing yourself from this pain. You're not allowing this pain or this person, their words, action, or deeds to dominate you. Okay. You're telling this person that, you know, you are in control. All right, Aquarius, and that pretty much sums up your spread, guys. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. Please subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And please don't forget to share, like, dislike, or comment below. For those of you that do want that reading with me, connect with me. Otherwise, please, everyone, take care, stay well, keep safe, and I'll catch up with you next week.